Oh my god, what the heck? What the f? Yo, first fish. No,
pay. When I die, put my money in a grave. When I die, put my money in a grave. I really gotta put a couple in a place. Really just lapped every in a race. I really might tap realest on my face. Lil CC, let it slap with the bass. I used to save, put a mask in a cave. Now I'm like, nah, love, I'm good, go away.
Yo, what is going on? We are back with another video. Finally, guys, I have been fishing way too much to not have another video out for you guys. It has been rough. Summer, dog days, you guys know the deal. It has been super rough trying to catch a good amount of fish. So we're actually gonna be doing something different for this video. Might actually get on some fish, we don't know yet. But I gotta be honest with you guys. I have a Baitcaster, right? I got it like 2 years ago. And it's kind of hard to say, but I don't think I've ever caught a fish on this Baitcasting combo. Let me show you really quick. So I'm sure you guys have seen me use this thing. It is a Luz Carbon Blue GT Speed Spool, 610 medium heavy. And really, it's just like the perfect combo to round out my arsenal. And I have a lot of like spinning combos, medium, like 6.6, all the way down to like 5.6. And this little bait casting reel is perfect for when, you know, you're trying to go after the big fish. So today I'm making it a personal mission to get on my first ever fish on a bait casting reel. I found it ridiculous that 2 years into fishing with this thing, I haven't caught a single fish on it. So let's get it rigged up. I'll show you guys what I'm gonna do with it and let's get on some fish. All right, y'all, finally had to dig around, but I finally found some line. So we're gonna be tying on some fluorocarbon. This is the Berkeley Vanish fluorocarbon. It's probably backwards for you guys, but it's Berkeley Vanish 12 pound. This should work perfectly on my Baitcaster, nice and heavy, but also very, very clear. Fish won't be able to see it. It was pretty expensive. And the knot I'm gonna be using, I actually learned from YouTube, from, I think it's called like saltwater fishing, or I don't know. It's like a saltwater channel, but it's called an Alberto knot. And I've been doing this for tying my leaders forever now, and it has yet to fail me. So we're gonna be using the Alberto knot. I'll be teaching you guys how to do that. Hopefully you guys can see. I have my black hoodie on, so that might help with the background. So what you wanna do is take your leader line, the fluorocarbon, so I have it right here, and you're just gonna make like a little loop, all right? Hold on to that. And then what you're gonna do is you're gonna take your main line. It could be braid, mono might work, but I've always used braid for fluorocarbon. And what you're gonna do is take it through the hole, and then you wanna wrap it around the fluorocarbon around 5 times. So wrap it around both lines. So I'm just gonna do that really quick. I'll show you what it looks like. And we'll do 6 just for extra measure. And then what you're gonna do is you're gonna go back towards the loop with the braid. You wrapped around that way. So you're gonna wrap back 5 times. So just do that.
2, 3, 4, 5.
And then once you still have your braided line here, you wrap over 5 times. Hopefully you guys can see that. And so you wrapped over 5 times, you wrapped back 5 times for a total of 10. What you're gonna do is you're gonna take the braid you were wrapping with and you're gonna put it back through the hole. And then all you gotta do is just lick it up and tighten it. Beautiful little knot. It should pass through your guides fairly easily. It's a very slim knot, and you just cinch it down all the way, make sure it's strong, and then take off the tag ends. All right, and just like that, we cut off the tag ends, and this wasn't my best knot, but I mean, that's pretty much what it's gonna look like. It's just a really slim knot that you can use. And once you have that, I like to have like a pretty decent length of a leader line. Right now I have probably like 4 feet long of just the leader line, because I like to retie my baits and I don't wanna have to keep retying a leader line. Once we have that, we can tie on our favorite lure. And today I'm thinking I'm gonna tie on a chatterbait, because might as well knock out 2 birds with 1 stone. First fish on a chatterbait and a baitcaster. Sounds like an epic day, so let's do that. All right, so here we have a little Z-Man chatterbait. This is like some type of craw color. It's a natural, very natural color. And chatterbaits are great baits to be using in slightly weedy waters, murkier waters, because it does give off that vibrating pattern, and it's also kind of like a jig, so it's very versatile. But what we're gonna be doing here to tie it on is a little palomar knot. And if you've never heard of a palomar knot, please look it up. I think it won some type of like competition as like the strongest knot. Correct me if I'm wrong, but this knot is probably the one of the most versatile knots I've ever used in my life. And we're just gonna be tying it on really quick. All right, y'all, we're here at the spot. Y'all seen it before, plenty of videos. So let's just get to it, got no time, let's get it. All right, y'all, lost a beautiful fish right here. And there's no way I'm fishing a chatterbait right there. Oh my God, what is going on? This looks freaking nasty, especially since the last time I came here. And I promise I don't suck at fishing. It's just, I usually use this Baitcaster for like really big lures, lures that are like low percentage. Now that we have a little chatterbait on, I feel like we have a way better chance of actually catching something. So without further ado, let's just get on a fish really quick. We just need to catch one fish on this Baitcaster and I'll be so happy. What the hell? That's a huge cat. What is that? It's a carp. Oh my God, what the heck? What the? Yo, first fish. Yo, what? What? I barely felt him. He barely picked it up. Look at this. He's not even fighting me. He's like not even fighting me. Oh my God. Yo, I was looking at a freaking carp over there. Yo, I can barely get him on. Oh my God, that's a big ass fish. What the? Oh my God, he barely picked it up. Yo, what? I wasn't even paying attention. I actually was not paying attention and this dude picked it up out of nowhere. There was like a, look, you guys can see it splashing over there. There's like a carp over there. I was looking at it and all of a sudden this freaking fish, oh my God, this is like pound and a half, maybe. Yo, first fish. What the freak? Yo, yo, look at this thing. Hell yeah, that's what I'm talking about, baby. That's what I'm talking about. Bass on a chatterbait, first ever bass on a freaking Baitcaster. Let's go, let's get hype. Get back in there. Oh, right in there. Oh my God, I barely even felt him. I didn't even set the hook. That was the weirdest freaking catch of my life. And of course, it's the first on a Baitcaster. Another one. What the frick? Oh, he came off. He came off. My God. What is going on? This chatterbait is freaking money. It has been so rough. And then the times that I don't get skunked, I'm catching like one fish at the most. And they're not big. So this feels good. Got a couple firsts out of the way here. These fish are pretty neat. There's another one. There's another one. Don't jump, don't jump, don't jump, don't jump, don't jump. Yo, number two, what the heck is going on? This chatterbait is so money. Look at this fish, look at this fish. Yo, technically number three, but number two that we actually landed. And here we go. Nice little lip here. Oh, hold on, buddy. Hold on, buddy. All right, got him. Look at this. Look at this chatterbait bass right here. Right in the top of the mouth, perfect hook set. Comes right out, and here we go. Second one of the day, let's go, guys. We're finally getting a decent day. And oh boy, that's an ambulance. All right, second one of the day, and we've been here for probably 15 minutes at the most. Already got two fish on a chatterbait. Guys, this is great. I've used chatterbaits probably two times before. I've gotten bites on them, but I've had such bad luck. I've been breaking off, catching literally nothing. So this feels great. All right, guys, that is just about going to do it for this video. I fished that spot for probably, I want to say half an hour at the most, and I had to leave really quickly. I came back actually and fished for another hour and I didn't catch anything, but got on two solid fish, so that was great. We actually were able to get on our first fish on a baitcaster and a chatterbait all in the same catch, or at least my first fish on a baitcaster within like 6 months or even more than that, probably a year. It's actually getting really chilly out now. It's like upper 50s, almost 60 degrees. It's 9:30 a.m. So we're starting to see a little bit of fall weather, which is kind of disappointing, but it's also kind of exciting because you know the fishing kind of turns up during the fall. So that'll be awesome. I can't wait to go on some awesome fishing trips, especially my kayak once it gets a little cooler and the water temps go a little down. Fish start going a little crazy. So stay tuned for those types of videos. But until then, hope you guys enjoy this video. As always, like, comment, subscribe, you know the deal. And I'll see you in the next one. Peace.